Hello, greetings to all of you. I am Dr. Ramesh Sharma and I welcome all of you in this massive open online course MOOC, which is targeted on the use of open educational resources in the classroom, and that's why it has been aptly titled as Teach Smarter with Open Educational Resources. In this course, since nowadays we are teaching in a 21st century digital classrooms, so open educational resources, they have a lot of importance here for the teachers and teacher educators. That's why this course has been launched by National Council for Educational Research and Training in association with Commonwealth of Learning, Canada. And the learning outcomes of this program is how we can evaluate open educational resources so as to identify the most relevant materials to the needs of the teachers and teacher educators, how the teachers, you as a teacher or as a teacher educator, you can adapt or adopt the open educational resources to your schools or institutions curriculum, how you can create additional open educational resources, how you can prepare the learners to fruitfully use open educational resources in their own learning environments, and a very important aspect of being aware about the copyright and the licensing issues related to open educational resources. A very brief introduction on how this term was coined. In fact, it was first used as the UNESCO conference in 2002, although these were in vogue much before that. For example, the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, their open courseware project, which began in the year 2001, they were in a way major contributors to the open educational resource movement. And since then, a lot of things have been created, and these are being used in many of the institutions around the world. The Commonwealth of Learning has defined the open educational resources as the materials which are offered freely and openly to use and adapt for teaching, learning and development and research. In addition, the OER Commons website, they also define that these are those teaching and learning materials which are freely available online to anyone to use, whether you are an instructor or a student or a self-learner. And the examples of open educational resources, they include like full courses, course module, syllabi, lectures, homework assignments, quizzes, lab, classroom activities, pedagogical materials, game simulation, etc. And these are various kind of products which can be created as open educational resources, like simulations, syllabi, full course, game, case study, audio lectures, video lectures, unit of study, training materials, textbooks, like that. Now, let me give a little bit overview of this course on open educational resources. It has certain topics like introductions to open educational resources, copyright issues, how these can be adopted, remixing, like how these can be adapted from other environments, how we can redistribute, and optional, there are certain new tutorials. So this is a 4-week program. We are starting with week 1, and in week 1 there are some topics, some activities, some discussions and some expectations from the course participants. They need to achieve those. So let me show you what are those topics. Here you will be introduced to the MOOC, that what a MOOC is, Massive Open Online Course. Yeah, you are participating in one of them. And then the introduction of how to teach in a 21st century, that is we will talk about the transition of the role of teachers from instructor to facilitator or enablers, and the open source software culture, and what is how it is setting the stage for open educational resource, and the case for open educational resources, what are open educational resources, how they have been evolved, etc. These are the topics which we will be covering in week 1. There are certain activities which you would be doing. like mapping yourself, and then as a part of discussion you would be introducing yourselves to rest of us. You can tell about your background, your intention, why you wanted to participate in this course. And in general, if you have a magic wand and could fix one thing about the way classroom teaching happens, so we would like to hear that, what would it be? And according to you, what should be the role of the teacher or teacher educator in 21st century? And finally, we would also discuss that, how to look for resources on the web to augment classroom teaching. And if so, what kind of issues do you face while searching for them? So these are the discussion points. And here are certain expectations that we would like you to have a fair idea about the emergence of the open source culture on the internet, and specifically for open educational resources in education. Be aware of the ways in which open educational resources could add value to the classroom. Be aware of the general copyright pitfalls of using resources from the internet and networking, social networking, introducing yourself to your participants, fellow participants, sharing your motivation of taking up this course, and what are your expectations you would be like to have from this course. So once again, I welcome all of you in this MOOC on open educational resources, and I wish you fruitful learning from this course. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful learning.